रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट और रिटर्न ऑन कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड. सो दिस रेशियो एनालिसिस विल शो द एफिशिएंट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द कैपिटल एम्प्लॉयड इन द फर्म, दैट इज द कैपिटल इन्वेस्टेड इन द फर्म, हाउ एफिशिएंटली इट हैज बीन यूज्ड इन द बिजनेस, एंड इट मेजर्स द ओवरऑल प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी ऑफ द कंसर्न. सो नेक्स्ट लेट्स सी द फॉर्मूला फॉर द रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट. So return on investment is a net profit before interest and tax, which will be given in the sum separately as an additional information, divided by the capital employed. So all these sums relating to return on investment will be on your balance sheet. So capital employed can be easily calculated using the labels given in the balance sheet or the divisions given in the balance sheet. So shareholder funds, you'll have a division called shareholder funds. Under it, what all items come, that is going to be your shareholder funds. Next is the non-current liabilities. So same, under non-current liabilities heading, whatever item comes, you can take it up for non-current liabilities. So when you add the both, you'll get capital employed. So in the 19th sum, we have to calculate the return on investment or return on capital employed. Both are the same. So first write down the formula for return on investment. So the formula for return on investment is net profit before interest and tax for the year, which is given separately in the last line of the problem, and capital employed. So capital employed is again shareholder funds plus non-current liabilities. So first let's calculate the capital employed. So I've written down the formula for capital employed, that is shareholder funds plus current liabilities. So I'm going to directly put in the value. So shareholder funds include share capital and reserves and surplus. So 2 lakhs plus 50,000. Non-current liabilities include only long-term borrowings, that is 1,50,000. So when I add it up, I will get 4 lakhs as my capital employed. So now I'm going to take this capital employed and put it inside the formula of return on investment. So return on investment, net profit before tax is given as 60,000 divided by capital employed of 4 lakh into 100. So cancel down the zeros. So 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros here, 4 zeros, 4 zeros, 1, 0, 1, 0. So 6 goes thrice, 4 goes twice, 2 goes once, 5 times. So 3 fives are 15% is the return on investment for this sum.